This question is on page 10, and we're looking at the functions, mostly focusing here on carbon. There are actually two questions on this page, so we'll look at both together. The first one says, which statement correctly describes how carbon's ability to form four bonds makes it uniquely suited to form macromolecules? So the four bonds, we're looking at that. It forms short, simple carbon chains. Well, it can. It forms large, complex, diverse molecules. It can. But we want to focus in on the bonds. It forms covalent bonds with other carbons. It forms covalent bonds that can exist in a single plane. And which one of these two things, so we can get rid of these, which one of these two things, these two bond answers, makes it uniquely suited to form macromolecules? And the answer for that is the C, that it can form covalent bonds with other carbon atoms, therefore being able to create these bigger, diverse macromolecules. Let's move over to the second question, which is using the diagram below to answer the question. We have a chemical reaction. We see one part here, we see another part here, coming to make one big molecule. So what we did was we have monomer number one, we have monomer number two, and then we have a polymer. And the diagram shows a reaction that forms a polymer from two monomers. What type of reaction is this? One of the things that comes out, sorry, the polymer goes to here. The thing that's coming out is water. So when water comes out, we've lost water, and that is dehydrating. We're building, and that is synthesis. So synthesis means to build. Water coming out is dehydrated. Our answer here is dehydration. So you look for the water coming out.